Hello everyone, welcome to KSV Kari Sarva Vishwavidyalaya University. In this video, we will discuss about atomic absorption spectroscopy. So let us start with the history. This technique was introduced in 1955 by a scientist Alan Walsh in Australia. It was the first commercial atomic absorption spectroscopy, and the first AS spectrometer was developed by this Alan Walsh scientist, and it was introduced in 1959. The main application of this spectroscopy is elemental analysis. So AAS is a quantitative technique which is applicable to many metals, few non-metals, and nowadays AAS is also applicable to metalloids. That means it is also used for the determination of non-metals, metalloids, etc. It is very reliable and simple to use. The main advantage of this technique is it can analyze over 62 elements in just one sample. For example, if your sample contains 50 to 60 elements, then this technique will help you to analyze each and every metals, non-metals, metalloids which are present in your sample. So as you can see, the elements which are highlighted in pink shade are analyzed or can be analyzed by AAS technique. So what is the principle of atomic absorption spectroscopy? It is a method of elemental analysis. It is particularly useful for the determining trace metals in liquids, and it is most independent of molecular form of metal in sample. No matter your metal present in which state, this technique is not dependent on the state of the matter. It just determines or detects your metals present in your sample. So this technique works on the absorption phenomena. It follows the laws of absorptions. So the principle is, when the sample solution is aspirated into the flame, the solvent is vaporized, leaving particles of the solid state. This solid salt burns and converted into the gaseous form, which is dissociated into free neutral atoms, and some of them excited by the flame heat. The remaining atoms present in the ground state absorbs the light of specific wavelength emitted by the lamp of same element to be determined, and the intensity of the light absorption is measured. So what happens in this technique? There is a light source, which is a radiation source, and we will supply our sample through the flame. So the flame temperature will vaporize a solvent which is used to dissolve our sample. So once a solvent is vaporized, the solid salt particles will be the remaining. So this salt burns and converted into the gaseous forms, which is dissociated into free neutral atoms by the flame temperature, and some of them will excite in the excited state, and the remaining atoms which are present in ground state will absorb the light which is passed from the radiation source of specific wavelength. Okay, and this light absorptions will be measured by the detector. So instrumental part of atomic absorption spectroscopy consists of radiation source, chopper, atomizer, monochromators, detectors, and readout device. This is the block diagram of atomic absorption spectroscopy. First part is this. This part is hollow cathode lamp. Okay, this is the radiation source. Means it passes the radiation of different wavelengths, and this is the flame in which our sample is introduced from here, from the bottom side. Here it is analyte sample in beaker. It is passed through a fuel air mixture, and it is passed into the flame where it vaporizes and atomizes. Okay, here sometimes in some instruments a chopper is a chopper is introduced, or chopper is used to convert the steady light into a pulsating light. So some instrument consists of chopper. Okay, the next is monochromator. Monochromator is mostly used for the separation or the filtration of polychromatic light. It converts a polychromatic light into a useful monochromatic light. Then there is a detector which detects the absorption of light. Then there is an amplifier and readout device. This is another instrumental diagram with more facility. Here it is a hollow cathode lamp, here it is a flame, here it is a slit, monochromator. As we know, monochromator may be prism or grating. Here it is a detector. We will specially discuss about HGAAS, that means hydride generation atomic absorption spectroscopy. This is an advanced technique of atomic absorption spectroscopy. It is mostly used for the detection of metalloids. Okay, the metals which are not directly detected in that metal state, like antimony, metalloids like antimony, arsenic, selenium, tellurium. These metalloids can be now analyzed by hydride generation AAS. So AAS is one of the commonest instrumental methods for analyzing for metals and some metalloids, but because of interferences, poor reproducibility and poor detection limits, an alternative method for some elements, mostly metalloids, has been developed, and this alternative method is known as hydride generation atomic absorption spectroscopy. It only requires the generation of hydride of these metalloids. So many parts of hydride generation AAS system are same as that of atomic absorption spectroscopy, like hollow cathode lamp, which is a radiation source, air acetin flame and detector, and relatively complex hydride generation system. The nebulizer required in AAS is not used in HGAAS. So nebulizer, which is usually used in AAS for atomization or for spraying the sample, is not used in hydride generation. The system described here is continuous flow system, but sometimes in past days, batch flow systems have been also used. So this is the diagram of hydride generator system. Here, the hydride generation reagents are used, which are 0.35% NaBH for sodium borohydride and 50% HCl. This is the most important question which have been asked in some exams, especially in short questions, like which are the reagents used in hydride generation system. So the answer is 0.35 NaBH4 and 50% HCl. This two reagents are used in hydride generation system. This is our sample here at the bottom. So these three solution are mixed in peristaltic pumps, and from that peristaltic pump, these three solutions are accelerated into the mixing or reaction coil. See, our sample and sodium borohydride and 50% HCl, these three solution are mixed in reaction coil. So from that reaction coil, our hydride is generated of the different metals, and then there is a gas or liquid separator which separates the hydride gas, and the another waste is drained out. So this hydride gas is then drive to the optical cell and heated in air acetylene flame. The reaction of many metalloid oxyanions with sodium borohydride and HCl produces a volatile hydride like H2TE, H2SE, H3AS and H3SB. Why we are generating hydrides of these metalloids? As I said, these metalloids cannot directly be analyzed by atomic absorption spectroscopy. So to detect this metal, we have to generate the hydrides of these metals. And for the generation of hydride, we are using hydride generator system. Okay, as with AAS, the oxidation state of metalloid is crucial, and so the care must be taken to produce the specific metalloid oxidation state before the sample is introduced into the hydride generation system. See, here we are using 0.35% NaBH4 and 50% HCl. So 50% HCl is highly acidic solution, so we have to take care while using this 50% highly acidic solution. The time of reagent mixing is also very important, and this is controlled by flowing reagents together using a peristaltic pump and tubing of specific length. After being mixed together, the liquid mixture flows through a tube of specific length and is ultimately flowed into a gas liquid separator, where the hydride and some gaseous hydrogen bubble out and are purged into the optical cell. Most of the reagents introduced into the system flow to a waste container, and since the acid content is very high, often approaching 50%, as with AAS, the waste container is a glass and must be handled carefully and labeled well. Some applications of AAS. AAS is widely used in all the fields, for example, clinical analysis, for analysis of biological fluids, metals in biological fluids such as blood and urine, environmental analysis, monitoring our environment, for example, finding out the level of various elements in rivers, sea waters, drinking waters, air, petrol, drinks such as wine, beer, and fruit drinks, pharmaceuticals. The most important field is pharmaceutical, in which atomic absorption spectroscopy is widely used. It is generally used in manufacturing processes, minute quantities of catalyst used in different processes. The amount of catalyst can be the amount of catalyst present can be easily determined with AAS, as catalyst is used in very small amounts, very trace amounts. So trace elements can be easily determined by atomic absorption spectroscopy. Industries, different industries, many raw materials are examined, and AAS is widely used to check that the major elements are present and that toxic impurities are lower than specified. For example, concrete, when calcium is a major constituent, the lead level should be low because it is toxic. Atomic absorption spectroscopy is widely used in the determination of toxic impurities in different, for example, food analysis, food poisons, different food samples can be easily analyzed for toxic elements by atomic absorption spectroscopy. It is also used in mining factories, mining fields. By using atomic absorption spectroscopy, the amount of metal such as gold in rocks can be easily determined to see whether it is worth mining the rocks to extract the gold. This mining analysis saves a lot of time. So atomic absorption spectroscopy is very useful in mining industry. Here I am sharing different color of flames of different elements. First the calcium flame. The color of the calcium flame is red. This is intensively red because the calcium content is very high, as I discussed in application part. The copper flame, it is bluish green. The potassium flame, suppose we are analyzing some sample for potassium present or absence, then we will see this color of flame, which is purple in color, so that will be a potassium present. Cobalt flame, manganese flame, greenish yellow type flame is observed when our sample contains manganese element. Now, let us solve some MCQs regarding atomic absorption spectroscopy, which are asked in different competitive exams or different external exams, university exams. First question is, what is the full form of HCl? So the full form of HCl is hollow cathode lamp. So fourth option is the right answer, hollow cathode lamp. It is the radiation source which is used in atomic absorption spectroscopy. Atomic absorption or base dash. So as I said, atomic absorption spectroscopy obeys laws of absorption as it is based on the absorption of radiation. So first option is correct answer, laws of absorption. Which gas is usually filled in hollow cathode lamp? So as we all know, HCl lamp, hollow cathode lamp consists of a inert gas. So in these options, only argon is an inert gas. So the correct answer is third option, argon. Usually argon inert gas is filled in hollow cathode lamp to generate the radiation. The purpose of the flame in atomic absorption spectroscopy is, so what is the purpose of flame in atomic absorption spectroscopy? It is dissolve it and atomize the analyte sample in the flame. Okay, so correct answer is second option, dissolve it and atomize the analyte atoms in the flame by its temperature, heating temperature. Okay, thank you so much for listening. That's all for this video. Thank you so much.